So hello friends, welcome to my channel Jobonymous, and in today's video we are going to discuss about TCS Smart Hiring 2021, where freshers as well as experienced person can apply. So in this video I am going to discuss about the full interview assessment, as to what will be the total rounds of the interview and what types of questions as well as their draft replies can be given for this role. And I'll also show you how you can apply for this role. So watch this video till the end so that you can completely understand the process. And in case you have landed new to my channel, consider subscribing it, because I make videos on job opportunities as well as interview preparation. So let's start today's video with the first thing, which is this drive. So this particular drive is for two types of students. One is for non-technical type of students and one is for technical. So for non-technical, this is for their TCS BPS division, which is known as business process sourcing. So the eligibility criteria for BPS is full-time graduates of BCom, BA, BAF, BBI, BBA, BBM, BMS, BSc, BCA, BCS and BPharma. They all can apply for this. So even science graduates as well as non-science graduates can apply for this. The only thing is that their year of passing should be only 2019, 20 and 21, and their age should be between 18 to 20 years here. They should also have no active backlog. Now the kind of job roles that they are willing to give in BPS role, so they will be related to banking and insurance, so finance types of roles, travel, tourism and hospitality, pre-sales, life sciences and healthcare, especially for the BPharma students, then media and information sciences and telecom. So these are the kind of divisions where you will be working in TCS BPS division. Now regarding the TCS IT division, for IT division only BSc, BCA and BVocation candidates can apply, and these are the subjects for which they should have studied in college: CS, IT, Statistics, Chemistry, Physics, Electronics, Biochem and Maths. Same year of passing should be 19, 20 or 21. Age limit should be between 18 to 28. No active backlog for 2019 and 20 passouts, but one active backlog is allowed for 2021 passout. Plus, for applying in TCS IT, you should have at least 50% of or 5 CGPA and 10, 12th and graduation. So friends, now I will also show you how you can apply for this role. So I have given the link in the description box. You will be redirected to this page where you can read about all the important things, the test details, the eligibility criteria and the frequently asked questions. So once you click on registration now open, you will be redirected to then this page, which somehow looks like this, and then you can choose wherever you want to apply, TCS IT or TCS BPS. So if you want to apply for BPS, you click on BPS and then you will be redirected to a page wherein you just have to fill in your personal details like name, date of birth and all other things, and then you can fill the form and you will be given a number which you have to use everywhere in the communication. So that I think you can easily do. So next we would move on to the interview rounds also. So just one more thing, regarding the salary details, it can range between 3 to 6 LPA depending on your stream, your performance in the interview and your experience if you have any, and location can be Pan India. Now we come to the more important things, which are the interview rounds. So round one is the aptitude test, which will be an online test. So friends, I have already created a video on Amazon's aptitude test, and TCS aptitude test will also be pretty similar, which will consist of three types of sections: numerical ability, logical reasoning and verbal reasoning. I have covered all these three sections in Amazon aptitude test also, so you can have a look at that, where I have shown some shortcuts, tricks, formulas that you can use to solve some tricky questions. So I've given the link in the description box. Once you clear that, there will be a technical round, especially for the TCS IT candidates, where they will ask you some programming related questions like based on arrays, strings, object-oriented programming, these kind of things, and then you will be there for HR or the managerial round. So regarding the aptitude test round 1, there will be 24 questions and 30 minutes will be given for you for verbal ability, and then there will be logical reasoning or reasoning ability type questions where they will give you 30 questions and 50 minutes. Last will be the numerical ability where they will give you 26 questions for 40 minutes. So friends, if you want me to make a separate video on TCS aptitude test also, I'll do that. But I need some candidates for that. So please do comment in the comments box that you want that aptitude test or not. Round 2, as I said, will be technical round where questions will be related to your stream and subjects. And then if you move to the round 3, there will be the HR or the managerial round. So friends, I have covered some questions that were asked in 2019 TCS Smart Hiring in the HR or the manager round, and I have also covered their sample answers that you can give. So I'll just show you. So first of all, they will ask you to introduce yourself, so you can prepare this thoroughly. You can talk about your family background, your education background, your interest, hobbies, and your work experience if you have any. Next, they can ask you why you want to join TCS. So here you can highlight good things about TCS, like their work environment, which is employee friendly. It is an MNC, so you will interact with people from different cultures. It has a good brand name, good work-life balance, as well as learning opportunities because their team is very experienced. Next, they can ask you what are your goals and aspirations. So here the tip is that goals are usually short-term and aspirations are long-term. So company here wants to check whether you will stay here for significant period of time or not. So you have to answer accordingly. Regarding your goals, you can say that you want to improve and hone your skills related to the role. They can be anything like communication skills, interpersonal skills, or any technical skill. Then learn new skills from your experience while working in teams and team management. So you want to learn team management skills and improve your knowledge about the working of company and the industry as a whole. So these can be your short-term goals. Regarding the aspirations, here you can say that I want to be in a leadership role like a department head, where I can demonstrate leadership skills and take strategic initiatives to grow the department as well as the company. Next, they can ask you what you prefer more, job satisfaction or high CTC. So here the tip is that always prefer job satisfaction over money. So a sample answer I have given which you can use. I would definitely prefer job satisfaction over high CTC. This is because if I would be doing work that suits me and gives me satisfaction, then I would also put in more efforts, which would help company to achieve its goal, which will eventually help me also to grow in career and get high CTC in the long term. Whereas if I would choose high CTC now, opposite may happen, which means that you may not be able to perform well in future and your growth will be very limited. Next, they can ask you how would you be an asset to TCS. So here I've prepared a sample answer for you. So most likely most of you will be fresher, so you can say that being a fresher, I'm ready to expose myself into different sectors of work as per the requirement of company. I am also flexible to relocate if required by the company. Moreover, I have the hunger to learn that always keeps me motivated. Lastly, I possess certain qualities like dedication and loyalty, which could prove extremely useful for your organization in the long run. So here you have shown that you are flexible to work in different kind of roles as well as relocate if required. And then you have shown that you possess dedication and loyalty, which will be good for company because it would mean that you would stay there in the long run. So next, they can ask you which you prefer, hard work or smart work. So friends, this is a very tricky question and many students fall trap into it and say that they prefer smart work because this is the trending thing, whereas this is not the case. Especially being a fresher, you should not focus more on smart work because smart work comes later on in your career. So a sample answer for this could be, I think smart work and hard work are related to each other. This is because we can only learn to do smart work once we become an expert in a particular trade which requires hard work. So smart work comes from the hard work only. Therefore, being a fresher, I believe hard work is more important for me at this stage. But as I will grow in my career and be given multiple responsibilities, I will have to do more smart work in order to be efficient. So this is the way you can answer this question, where you have highlighted the importance of both hard work and smart work, but depends on where you are in your career. Hard work is important when you are at an entry level position. Later, smart work comes into play. So this is how you can answer this question. Because if you will only concentrate on smart work, you will come across as a manipulator in the eyes of the company. So be very careful while answering this question. Next, they can ask you about, tell me about a time you failed. So here the tip is that they are asking this question to know how you bounce back from failure. So don't shy from admitting failure. Everyone fails in life sometimes. Show how you dealt with failure and your learning from failure, and use the STAR approach, which is a situation, task, approach, result approach, which you can use. So I have prepared a sample answer for you. So during, you can say something like that, during my third year in the college, I had to present project work to the professor. It was a team project and I had three more members with me to work on the project. So this was the situation. Now the task that was given to you, since I had good hold of that subject, our professor made me the leader of my team. I also got very excited to hear that and began to work on the project by myself. My team members also asked me to divide project work among them so that it can be completed on time. So this was about the task. Then the approach or the action you took. However, I had low confidence on my team members and decided to do all the work by myself. But couple of days before the project presentation date, I realized that I was lagging behind and may not be able to complete the project on time. So I decided to also give work to other team members, but since I hadn't involved them from the start, they had difficulty in understanding as to what exactly needs to be done. So result, as a result of that, our final project presentation was also not up to the mark, and professor also criticized the project work. So this is how you can use this STAR method. But after that, you should always highlight the learnings that you got from that failure. So I felt extremely disappointed, but I understood that the value of teamwork and also realized that one should never become overconfident. So in the final year, when I was again involved in a project, I involved my team members right from the start of the project and it went way better than the last time. So now this is the learning you have shown. So this is the way you can answer this question. Now next is, are you willing to relocate if required by a company? So here you can be given any location in India. So you can say that although my first preference would be my birth city, but if required by the company, I can relocate as I can adapt to changing environment. During my college years also, I lived away from my family in a different city. So I know what adjustments are required for relocation. So this is the way you can handle this question. So friends, now we move on to the last question that I have prepared for this video, that why should we hire you? This is an extremely important question and it is very important to answer this correctly. So I have prepared a video on that, a separate video where you would know how you can answer this question if this is asked by the company. So the link has been given in the description box. So friends, these were about the 2019 TCS part hiring questions, which I have taken from several websites on the internet. And I would want you to subscribe to this channel so that once this year's TCS Smart Drive will happen, I will also include more questions that will be asked from candidates and make a new video on the 2021 new questions if they haven't been covered in this video. And if this video has been useful to you in any way, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. And I'll meet you in the next video. Till then, bye-bye.